Hello, we are again welcome for our devotion, and the title is Planning for the Future based on James 4:13 up to 17. Now, there are people when they plan, they think of their future, they're very optimistic, very positive. Others are very pessimistic. They see dark clouds, unhappy future, and so on. So we can see different kinds of people here who are thinking of their future. Now, we ask this question, how shall we plan for our future based on James 4:13 up to 17? And the first is this one, forsake our illusion of control over our life. We have to negate the idea that we are totally in control of our future, of our life. Now, Illusion of Control by Ellen Langer is an expectancy of a personal success probability inappropriately higher than the objective probability you would warrant, would warrant. Point here is that sometimes we expect too much of our ability to control our future, our life. The illusion of control is the tendency for people to overestimate their ability to control events. But in reality, for example, this pandemic, it's out of control. It's not in our hands. You know, it just happened like this. Now, the words of James in the passage we read, like this. Now, listen, you who say, today or tomorrow, we will go to this or that city, spend a year there, carry on business, and make money. Why? Do you not even know what will happen tomorrow? Why? You do not even know what will happen tomorrow. What is your life? You are a mist that appears for a while and then vanishes. So, for those who are thinking of their future and planning this way and that way, the words of James is saying, listen, the emphasis here, listen, you know, those who are planning for the future to do this or that. Why? You do not even know what will happen tomorrow. You don't know if you are still alive tomorrow, especially in our time of pandemic now. What is your life? You are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes. Just like a mist, a water vapor. You're here and then vanishes. So, for those who are thinking that they are fully in control of their lives, James is warning them like this. Now, Jesus Christ told a story of a rich fool in Luke 12:13 up to 21. And this rich person, he has a very wide plantation, and the plantation yielded a lot of, fruits and then harvests. And then he's saying, yes, what shall I do now? I'm going to destroy all my small barns and build bigger barns so I can put all the harvest here, and then after that I'll just relax and be happy and eat and drink, you know, that's what I'll do. But then God said to him, tonight you will die. You see, this story of Jesus Christ tells us that our future, we are not really in total control. How many people just sleep in the night and then cannot wake up in the morning? They have many ambitions and plans. How many poor and rich people died in this time now of pandemic? Now, the point of Jesus Christ in this story is, do not just think of your material wealth on this earth, you know? You may be rich in your material wealth. If you are not rich in God, you don't think of your spiritual life. You are pitiful. You are a fool. That's the point of the story. Now, what shall we do then? Let us entrust our future to God's providence, or to God's control, or to God's will. You see, God is the one really in control of everything, even our future. We who believe in Him, we believe that God has wonderful plans for His people in our future. So we are encouraged to entrust our future to God. Now, in James 4:15-17, you know, the continuation of the passage, instead, right? So it's the opposite. So James was saying, those people who just say today or tomorrow we will go to this or that city, spend a year there, carry on business and make money. You don't just do like that. Instead, you ought to say, if it is the Lord's will, we will leave and do this or that, or make business or make money or whatever, if it is the Lord's will. Now, such kind of thinking, yes, we still plan, we still think of our future, we still work for it, but then we say, if it is the Lord's will, if the Lord will still be gracious and merciful to me, if it is by God's, it is the Lord's will. So here we are entrusting to God, who is in total control, our future, our life. We don't just say, yes, I'm going to do this. No, according to this passage, as it is, you boast in your arrogant schemes. You are boasting of your plan. All such boasting is evil. Such kind of boasting your plans without God, it is evil. Right? If anyone then knows the good they ought to do and doesn't do it, it is sin for them. So this is what we call the sin of omission. If you know that it is good and you do not do it, it is a sin. Now, in saying this, if this is good, if you don't do this, then it is sin. Alright, if it is the Lord's will, this is good. This is what we should do as believers in God, who are submitting our life to Him, who is really in control of everything. We say, if it is the Lord's will, if it is God's will, we will do this, we will plan this, we will make this, we will do business, we'll make money or whatever, we'll construct this, if it is the Lord's will. So we are not negating putting God aside, but putting Him at the center of what we are planning and doing. So this is the message of James for those who are thinking of their future. Now, Jesus Christ also said, therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothes? Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Can any one of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? So don't worry about your future, about tomorrow, what you do, what you eat or drink. You know, the birds, God is taking care of them. Then, consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin, yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is today is alive and tomorrow is thrown in the oven, will He not much more clothe you, O you of little faith? Therefore, do not be anxious, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? For the Gentiles seek all of these things, and your Heavenly Father knows that you need them. But seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. Therefore, do not be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble.
Hallelujah.
So even the flowers, you know, God clothed them beautifully. No need for them to worry. No need for us to worry about our future. We just entrust our tomorrow, our needs, even in the future, to our God. But then we are encouraged to seek first His kingdom and His righteousness. See, let God reign in our life today and tomorrow. Let us allow God to rule our lives. And all these things shall be added unto you. Hallelujah. My dear brothers and sisters, even in this uncertainty, we are in this pandemic. We have a God who holds our tomorrow, who is in control of our future. You see, my dear brothers and my sisters, we have a Father who cares for His children. Let us entrust our plans, our future, to our God. There's a song, "I Don't Know About Tomorrow," and this is a, you know, what is stated in the phrase or in the stanza. It says, "Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand. Oh, but I know who holds tomorrow, and I know He holds my hand." And then it adds like this: fear not tomorrow. God is already there. Already there. Yes. Hallelujah. God is already there in our future. So let us entrust our future, our plans to God, even our tomorrow. Even in this time of uncertainty, of pandemic, God is there in our future. Let us pray. Lord, thank you for reminding us not to boast of our plans, but to entrust our plans unto you, O Father. You are the one who really in control of everything. And we ask for your forgiveness that in many times, in many ways, we are thinking that we are the one in control of our lives. So we say sorry for that. And this time we are reminded to always submit to you, Lord. If it is your will, if it is your will, Father, we come to you that you will help us survive this pandemic. If it is your will, our plans, our future will be great, oh Father. If it is your will, you work your plans in our lives, oh Father. We pray that you are going to work wonders in our lives and through our lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Your name be glorified. We just entrust everything, even our future, our life, to you. And everyone listening this time, we pray for your special touch, special reach for them, O Father, that you bless them. You also take care of them and provide all their needs, even we entrust their tomorrow. Hallelujah. We just entrust everything into your hands, today, tomorrow, our future. Hallelujah. We know that you are in control. This is a prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless.